The United States needs and deserves courageous and creative senior leaders for a secure future. Smart, thoughtful, innovative leaders of character who are prepared for complex problem solving and team building with allies and partners at the strategic level.
One of the first qualities that I'd point to is the ability to look at complex problems, identify the core elements of those complex problems and the implications of those core elements, and then to be able to communicate to people about the nature of that particular problem and then how to frame it so you can actually solve it.
Our people are our most important resource, our most important weapon system, and I think professional military education is absolutely key to producing the world-class army that we have today.
Our war colleges, they are tackling our problems. They're focused like a laser on our strategic problems and developing those leaders who will be able to build that bridge between our political goals and our available means and ways. That's critical to the future of the nation. That's critical to securing our nation.
That's why we have an Army War College. In 1901, when Secretary of War Elihu Root established the Army War College, he anticipated an educational institution that could be a catalyst for educating, planning, and preparing senior military officers to be strategic-minded and lead change. In its early years, the college provided planning support to the War Department, but with the nation's entry into World War I, the school closed from 1917 to 1919, when graduates like John Pershing, John Lejeune, and Tasker Bliss planned and led operations on the battlefields of Europe. During the interwar years between World Wars I and II, the Army War College continued to contribute directly to the Army staff's production of planning documents, and much of their effort resulted in the Rainbow Plans that were developed to meet the threat of a two-ocean war against multiple enemies. Army War College graduates Dwight Eisenhower, Omar Bradley, George Patton, and William Halsey studied at the school during the interwar years, preparing for the strategic challenges of World War II. The school closed again to meet the wartime demands for Army leaders. In 1950, Army Chief of Staff General J. Lawton Collins reestablished the college to meet the enduring need for officers with advanced education. After a temporary period at Fort Leavenworth, the Army War College reopened in 1951 at Carlisle Barracks, Pennsylvania. Carlisle Barracks has proved to be uniquely postured to put leader development first, and Carlisle has been an enduring good neighbor. Over the past 65 years, War College graduates led in the Korean and Vietnam conflicts. They rebuilt the Army in the years leading up to the first Gulf War and into the new millennium. Since 2001, Army War College graduates have led operations associated with Iraq and Afghanistan, and counterterrorism. Despite the surging demand for leaders in the operations following September 11, 2001, the school has remained open, recognizing the critical need to invest in leader development for the nation's future. Today, the Army War College develops students to be critical and innovative thinkers, inspired to serve, and able to exercise wisdom and strength in decisions that will shape the future, not to promote war, but to preserve peace.
You'd expect somebody that comes out of here to have an appreciation of history, so they have a reference when they're solving these problems. You'd expect somebody to come out of this school able to do critical thinking and get after what I defined earlier as those most important elements of complex challenges. You'd expect people to come out of here with a better appreciation. There's, I think, now 80 international students here, plus 40 or 50 members of the U.S. government and our agency that are here. And so if they haven't at this point in their career been exposed broadly, internationally, if they haven't been at this point exposed to the rest of the U.S. government and our agency, then my expectation is that the interchange that takes place inside the seminar and inside the larger groups is going to give them, you know, some of the skills they'll need as they move forward. Certainly the base, the foundation for those skills.
The Army War College has changed and developed since 1901 and now serves the nation with both strategic education and strategic ideas, strategic wargaming, test plans and ideas. Historical analysis deepens understanding of today's problems. Strategic research anticipates and examines emerging issues. The college's decision analysis capabilities helps senior leaders define complex problems, explore the complexity, and think through the consequences of decisions.
What it does is it begins to give you a framework and gives you a background about how you can begin to think about problems that you're dealing with and how you might approach them to solve them for our nation.
The curriculum evolves to anticipate leaders' needs in changing environments. And in 2017, because of its expertise in strategic education, the Army War College mission expanded to general officer education for the Army.
It's like going to the gym, going to be educated, right? You're exercising muscle, you're pumping blood into muscles. When you're in education, it's pumping blood into your brain. It's expanding your thought. It's teaching you how to think differently, how to receive information, how to translate that information, how to articulate that information.
The campus at Carlisle creates a broad community for professional leader development.
Coming out of War College, we expect them to come in with energy, having been filled up by the great academics that happened here and the experiences that they have here and the things they learned from their teammates and colleagues. We expect them to bring some of those relationships again with them. They will know people who will be in other places that can help any organization they go to. So we want to see a connected graduate of the War College. But then finally, as an individual, what we're looking for is someone who can think, that can contribute, to operate at echelons probably above which they have previously served. The War College should prepare them for those very high echelons of command and staff, and eventually to take the place of people like me.
Leadership is a fundamental component. It's the most important component, in my mind, of combat power. And we, the Army, spend an awful lot of money, time, effort, resources in developing our leaders, and that's as it should be.